and she fire. Brown skin, pretty brown eyes, slim waist, but her hips kinda wide, thick thighs. She about 5'5 or about 5'6. Pretty tits and high.
Hey, you guys! What's going on? How you doing? I just recorded another video, so let me shut up because that's so annoying. But hey, y'all, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Chichi, and we're back with another video. Today's video, as you can tell from the title, is about dealing with anxiety during quarantine. I wanted to give y'all like some help because your girl deal with anxiety on a daily basis as well. And I just wanted to give you all some tips on how I have been combating it. And you know, being in the house can really take a toll on your mental. And you know, for all you all that are dealing with anxiety, you know, it all starts up here, where you know, most of the time we are like overthinkers and we think too hard, we think too long, we think the worst, and it just causes us to pretty much panic. Okay, and you know, when you have so much time like now to be just sitting in the house, and some of us are really, really scared of this pandemic, it can cause us to have anxiety attacks. And I just wanted to really go through some things that really helped me when I feel like I'm on set of anxiety, and how I really like just shut it down and shut it out. Seriously. The main thing I love to do when I feel anxiety coming on is, now it's different extremes. Okay, now if you have anxiety, then you know what I'm talking about. Like, sometimes you feel it coming on, and sometimes it just hits you like a ton of bricks. Like, sometimes you just boom, like you just automatically into straight up, not like that, but sometimes you just automatically into like straight up panic mode. When I feel anxiety creeping up on me, the first thing I like to do is just like sit down, take a deep breath. Because for me, when anxiety creep up on me, I normally feel it here and my chest tightens. So I just sit down, take a deep breath, or stand still, take a deep breath. I automatically feel like people know what's going on with me, so I automatically start thinking that I look crazy, and it just goes from there. But yeah, so I sit down, I stand, or I just pretty much pause. I take a pause and I take a deep breath, and I try and I recite this scripture, which is from, I had to write it down, which is from 2 Timothy 1:7, which says, "For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, of love, and a sound mind." Okay? So to all my Christians out there, and to everyone, seriously, like to everyone, God did not give you a spirit of fear. And that is literally the root of anxiety, fear. And I remind myself that that is not what God has given me. He has given me a sound mind. And I tell myself that I have a sound mind, and it calms me down. I even go to the point of rebuking the devil, because the devil is fear, because the devil comes to kill and steal your joy, and that's exactly what he's trying to do when anxiety creeps in. So I cast him out, I say the scripture, and I remind myself that God gave me a sound mind, and he did not give me this spirit of fear, and there's no reason to be scared. There's no need for me to be worried, because God handles everything. He covers me, and there's no need to be fearful. Okay? So that's the first thing. So when it comes, when it's creeping up on me, I remind myself of that. Okay? Now, when it comes to those ones where it's just kind of strong, like, from the jump, I tend to try to calm my mind to which is hard. That's why I'm like squinting my eyes, because I'm telling you how to calm your mind, and I know that that's hard to do. But I try to calm my mind and try to go to a place of nostalgia that makes me happy, that makes me calm. So for me, normally it's springtime. I don't know why I love the springtime. It's very nostalgic for me. Sometimes I even go as far as like whatever recently made me feel good, I think about that to revisit that feeling again, and it calms me down. Sometimes when it's really, really bad, I just call my mom. Mom! No, but for real, my mom's voice is very calming to me. So, like, I can call her and she don't even know that I'm calling her because I'm having anxiety. And just her talking, she be like, "Yes, Kay, what's going on?" And, you know, that alone, like, just her voice alone is very calming to me. So as far as being in the house, the biggest thing that I have been doing is trying to stay within my routine, planning to wake up at like around like normal and keep a normal schedule, go outside, walk around. You're quarantined, but you can go out in your neighborhood and walk around, breathe some fresh air. What else? I get dressed, like I get cute, take selfies. That always makes me feel good. Like I literally sit around. I don't try to sit in the house and lay in the bed all day, because eventually you get bored, and then when you get bored, your brain wanders, and then you have anxiety. But those are the biggest things I feel like. Reciting the scripture. Revisiting nostalgic moments that make you feel good. Keeping a constant routine, a constant daily routine, just so that you don't find yourself not being busy and you don't give yourself time to overthink. And getting cute. That works for me. I like getting cute and taking selfies and feeling like I'm going somewhere. And I know I'm not, but the pictures made it to Instagram, so it's whatever. So yeah, so those are the four things that really have been helping me through this time. I just wanted to come on here and I just wanted to share with you all really pretty much how that really helps me, because it's tough out here. We just got told that we gotta go another 30 days, like, in the house. Like, it's gonna get worse. And I wanna put this video out so that all y'all who have dealing with anxiety like me can know what to do and know how to chill and calm your brain. Because God gave you a what? A sound mind. And he did not give you what? The spirit of fear. No, but for real, y'all, we're gonna get through this. We really are. I've honestly been enjoying this time. This is really time to get close to family. This is time to get to, you know, find something else new about yourself, start a business, start a hobby, start something. Like, literally, you have nothing to do. Like, literally. So, I mean, just the pot. And then look at the positive side of it, too. A lot of us really was just, everybody pretty much was just on the go. Like, we really had no choice but to pause that constant on the go and enjoy life. Seriously. And another thing, turn off the goddamn news. Turn it off. Because the news is created to scare us. It is created to install fear in us so that we can be controlled. So grab the information you need to grab and cut it off. Because I'm telling you, after 12 noon, you don't need to keep watching that. You don't. They're saying the same thing over and over again. And trust me, you're going to get tired of it. You're going to get sick of it. And then you're going to get scared and have an attack. Like, turn the TV off. Turn the TV off. Go off that. Well, go to your front door. Front yard, if you have one. Because, yeah, that's just going to scare you. But okay, you guys. Thank you all for watching. I hope that the things that help me can help you and be of use to you. And if it do, let me know. Don't forget to follow me on social media, y'all, because, you know, that's where I be at on a daily. I be in club quarantine or whatever. So if y'all go in there, let me know. And if you buy me a drink, let me know. I be there. Say no. I'm joking. But yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.